Very good evening. Today, I summarize what we have discussed up to now during last 13 weeks. First of all, let's open the data file. Open the data file and let's discuss the topics I have covered up to now. The topics basically we discuss regression analysis, start from the multiple regression analysis and by using the multiple regression analysis by using ordinary least square method, then we check the Gass-Markov theorem. That means in regression we made an assumptions. These assumptions we call the Gass-Markov theorem. Based on these assumptions, we use the ordinary least square method to analyze the data. The problem is just analyzing by using OLS is not enough. We need to check whether all assumptions are fulfilled or not. Now, Mr. Vithanage, so then you haven't uploaded your data set. Before coming to the lecture, I check you have not uploaded the, I couldn't find, so then you have not uploaded the data files. If you were data file is with you, analyze it, but I analyze my data file I have already uploaded to the LMS. Go to the LMS and then download the data file. And this is the data file. Right, here there are many variables in the data file. Consider, for the sake of the simplicity, consider the real exchange rate. Real export, REX, is the dependent variable. Consider REX as a dependent variable. If you have your own data set and consider the dependent variable and then what is your independent variables. Real exchange rate is in this case dependent variable. And real exchange rate, RER is real exchange rate. REX is the dependent variable. REX means a real export. RER means real exchange rate. It is also the independent variable. one independent variable. They assume for the sake of the simplicity, real exchange rate is the dependent variable. Real export is the dependent variable. Real exchange rate is the one independent real GDP, RGDP, consider in this list of variables, RGDP means real GDP, income of the country. This is also the another independent variable. Then our model in this case, assume that you want to check factors that affect or that whether exchange rate impact for the export of the country. Then build your model like this. Y, that means real export is a function of alpha, real export is a function of, so then instead of alpha, I could write it here, A, S, R, E, R, R, G, D, P, plus there is an error, E. Right, this is our model. Then we want to, series are the time series. Assume that your data set is the cross-sectional. Right, you assume that your data set is the cross-sectional. But this is the time series data. Let's analyze this data set, this equation, by using ordinary least square method. Right, what's our first? What you need to do is go to the quick. Go to the quick and series group statistics, and then check correlation. Before that, it is better if you can do the graph. So the graph, we list the variables in which you want to draw graph. In this case, there are three variables, real export, real exchange rate, and real GDP. Then click OK. But in the graph option, there are many types, mostly the line graph. Draw the line graph for each variable. This is because it's a time series data. The single graph means all three variables in one graph, but we want separate graph for each variables. Then select multiple graph. Then select multiple graph. Then click OK. Now you can see there are different types of graph for each variables. Graph for each variables. Right, then after graphing, then check whether there is a relationship between variables. then go to the group statistic quick, go to the quick, then go to the group statistics. In the group, under the group statistics, go to the correlation. Right, list the series, list all the variables in which you consider. First, give the your dependent variable, real export, real exchange rate, and real GDP. Now click OK. Right, this is the output. Then we can see the real export and the real exchange rate. There is a positive relationship. You can see that correlation is a weak relationship. Relationship is 0.04, and the with real GDP and the real export, there is a moderate, approximately 7, moderate positive relationship between real GDP and real export. Right, so here real export and the real exchange rate, the correlation value is 0.044. It means that if you want, write it here, the correlation of real export and real exchange rate0.04. Is that there is a weak positive relationship and similarly, the relationship real export, the relationship correlation value, correlation value of real export, real GDP is 0.65. There is a moderate positive relationship between real export . Right, then there is a no relationship, so then you can see that there is a weak relationship between real export and real GDP. Then we can go with the next step. Right, this is the prerequisite, so we can see that there is a positive relationship between real exchange rate and the real export. There is a positive, moderate relationship between real export and real GDP. If you have your own data set, first check the correlation, whether there is a relationship between the variables. That is the prerequisites to go for the next level. Then the correlation, keep remember, correlation measures the strength of the relationship. Which three.
Yes.
You can see that strength, correlation measures the strength of the relationship. For example, a relationship between real export and the real exchange rate. Strength is, there is a positive relationship, but the strength is weak positive relationship. But on the other hand, the relationship between real export and real GDP, there is a positive relationship. The strength is, there is a moderate positive relationship. Then, correlation measures the strength of the relationship between variables. Then go to the next step. After checking the correlation between variables, then next step is to go for the regression. Go to the quick group statistics. Go to the quick and estimate equation. Go to the quick and then go to the estimate equation. If the path is, go to the quick and then estimate equation. This is the way to, you are given in this example, equation look like this. First give the constant term. First give the dependent variable. In our dependent variable is real export, REX. Then the constant term, alpha, OA. Then real exchange rate. Then real, those are the variables we consider. Then the method is least square method. In the least square method, we assume that in the least square method, we assume the error term is normally distributed. There is a no relationship between independent variables. For example, real exchange rate and real GDP, those are our independent variable. We assume that there is no relationship between independent variables, right? Also, we assume that there is a no past value impact for the present value. That is, the lag variables do not include to the model. Also, we assume that our sample has an equal variance, then the error term, otherwise it disturbs to the error. We assume that based on these assumptions, we can estimate the model by using least square method. Then after equation specification, with the equation specification is important, give the dependent variable first, then constant term, then your real exchange and independent variable, and then your another. If you have, you know, that many independent variables, you list all the independent variables you consider. Then click OK. Right, this is your regression model. In the regression model, how to interpret this regression model? Interpret the regression model. First, pay your attention for the R square. Right, in this case, R square is 0.44. that is R square explain the explanatory power of the mod. It mentioned the explanatory power of the model. It is explanatory power of the model. That means 44% is explained by the dependent variable by RER and RGDP, these two variables. What is left is 56% is left. 56% is explained. It means that the other variables you do not consider for analyzing the real export, those are 56%. That 56% goes to the error term. Then the next step is, first, when you regress your model, first the graph, right, graphically illustrate your H variables. Then, next step is correlation. Get the correlation table and interpret the correlation table. Correlation shows the strength of the relationship between variables. After the correlation analysis, then you can go for the next step, because correlation table shows there is a relationship between variables. It is a prerequisite to go to the regression analysis. In the regression output, first pay your attention for the R squared, then F statistics. In the statistics, the probability value of F statistics should be less than 5%. But in this case, in this example, in this model, 0.000. That means it is less than 5%. Accept a model as a whole is good or satisfactory or good or significant. Like in this case, if a statistics, the null hypothesis is, all independent variables, no relationship, there is no relationship with dependent variable and independent variables, right, as a whole. That is null hypothesis. Alternative hypothesis is there is a relationship then variable and independent variables. If the probability value of the F statistic is less than, this value is less than 5%, means we accept there is a relationship as a whole between dependent variable and independent variables as a whole. Then we need to go to the another step by step interpretation, then go to the T values, T statistics. In the T statistics, probability value corresponding to the T statistics than 5%. In this case, real exchange rate, you can see real exchange rate probability value is greater than 5%. That the what is the T statistic shows? T statistics statistics overall significance. T statistics individual variable significance of individual variables. F statistics overall significance as a combination of both variables, whether our model is significant or not. In the t-statistic shows individual each variable separately, real exchange rate separately, real GDP separately. Whether real exchange rate variable is significant or real GDP variable alone is a significant. How to check that? Probability values corresponding to the t-statistics of each variables should be less than 5%. But in this case, real exchange rate probability value is 0.34. It is 0.34. It is greater than 5%. It means that there is no significant impact rate has no significant impact on real, no significant impact on real export, real exchange rate. There is a relationship, but the relationship is positive, but there is a no significant impact. At the same time, consider the real GDP. In the real GDP, probability value is less than 5%. RGDP the probability T value less than 5%. their GDP has a significant impact on their export. Right, that is, the analysis is not end by using these statistics. Then your analysis, these results, those are our conclusion. In the conclusion, we can say real GDP is a significant impact for real export of the country, but the real exchange rate do not a significant impact to explain the real GDP, to explain the real export. Then that is our conclusion. But we cannot conclude our results based on this information. We need to test whether our assumptions we made, because ordinary least square method is based on some assumptions, few assumptions. To validate this output, this conclusion, we need to check the model efficiency. Check the model efficiency. Model efficiency, under model efficiency, to check the autocorrelation we need to check the equal variance means we use the term, technical term is multicollinearity. Multicollinearity means equal variance. We need to check the multicollinearity. Collinearity means relationship between independent variables. But we can check this by using correlation table. Using a correlation table, we can check whether there is a relationship, strong relationship between real exchange rate and the real GDP. But in the correlation table shows that there is no such a strong relationship, then we can confirm that there is no multicollinearity issue in this model. Then we want to check the normality. Normality means whether our residuals are normally distributed. Residuals means all these assumptions for our residuals. What is our residuals means? That is error term. Error term. Assume that autocorrelation. In practice, for example, in practice we know that export depends on the last month export as well. If in this model we do not consider this as an independent variable, if we do not consider the past value for the real export depends on the past last year real export, we do not consider this variable. If we do not consider this variable means it goes to the error term. That is 56% that goes to the error term. Also the multicollinearity means, heterozygosity, equal variance means not multicollinearity, it is heterozygosity. Heterozygosity means equal variance whether our sample has an equal variance. No significant difference of our sample. Normally time series data we don't have heterozygosity issue. But heterozygosity issue mostly we can see in cross-sectional data. Also the normality. Normality, we can check normality by using Jacques-Vera test. It is error term. In our error term, each error values, values should be normally distributed. Then those are the assumptions. These four are the assumptions we made for analyzing the ordinary least square. If one of these assumptions violate the output, our conclusion is real GDP is a significant impact for explaining real export. Real exchange rate is not the significant variable. That is our conclusion. So then this conclusion is valid if our model fulfill these four assumptions. That is very much important thing. Most of the researchers, research students, they just put the regression output, only regression output, and then conclude. That is interpreting R squared, F statistics and T statistics, that's it. But that is not enough to conclude, because ultimate this conclusion for policy decisions. Right, so then in this case, in this example, it says that real exchange rate do not impact. But real GDP it impact. But that is ultimately we conclude that for policy decisions, policy makers to take decisions. When based on this conclusion, if the policy makers will assume that policymakers take decisions based on this assumption, it is not practically applicable, and then it is it creates another problem to the economy. Then that's why we want to check whether we did any mistake. Right, whether we consider that, whether past value impact for the present scenarios, whether it impact, whether independent variables impact for the relationship, there is a relationship among independent variables to check it, whether normality, our errors are normally distributed or not. Right. Then we call this model efficiency. Assume that all these assumptions fulfill, then our model, this model can be used for conclusion. Otherwise, our conclusion, our results are nonsense. That's why I explained it is spurious regression results. Now let's check what is autocorrelation, what is heterozygosity, what is multicollinearity, and what is normality. Right, now if you have your own data set, first analyze the data set by use correlate, check the correlation, then analyze by using ordinal least square method, then get the output, and now check whether all these assumptions are fulfilled or this model. If all assumptions fulfilled, this model is satisfactory or significant for conclusion and the prediction for the future. Right now, first check autocorrelation, model efficiency, autocorrelation. Correlation can be checked by mostly times if your data set is time series, normally autocorrelation problem you can see. If it's a cross-sectional data, mostly you can see the heterozygosity issue. Autocorrelation can be checked. There are many methods to check. Simple method is Durbin-Watson statistics. Here you can see Durbin-Watson stat. Right, it is Durbin-Watson statistic. Approximately, it should equal to. Right, if Durbin-Watson statistics is approximately 2, there is autocorrelation. There is no autocorrelation. But in this case, in our example, Durbin-Watson value is 0.9467. It is less than 2. It is very less than 2. It means there is a positive autocorrelation. It's a positive autocorrelation. Right, then the Durbin-Watson statistics is less than 2. In this case, it is 0.94. Then our model is suffering from autocorrelation issue. Then it's a serious issue. If the model is suffering from autocorrelation, we cannot use this model for conclusion. Then there is another method to check the correlation. Go to the weave and the residual diagnostics. Under the residual diagnostics, residuals means error diagnostics, there are many methods. Then there is a icon here, serial correlation LM test. Right. So then the serial correlation, go to the view and the residual diagnostics. Under the residual diagnostics, we need to check all these. Go to the serial correlation LM test. Legs, number of legs to include. In the number of legs, there are two legs is enough. It's a annual data, sorry, quarterly data. It's two quarters. Then click OK. Right, then this is the probability chi-square value. Probability chi-square value corresponded to the R-square. This probability chi-square value, then the autocorrelation. Our null hypothesis is no autocorrelation. Alternative hypothesis is autocorrelation. If the probability value, if the chi-square probability value less than 5%, decision rule, we accept null hypothesis. We accept alternative hypothesis. But in this case, probability value, chi-square probability value is 0.000. It is less than 5%. Alternative hypothesis that there is a correlation. One assumption is violated, as shown in the same results we got the we got from Derwin Watson statistics essay. Now check the heteroscedasticity. The null hypothesis is no heteroscedasticity. Alternative hypothesis is right. So then here, what is Broch-Godfrey serial correlation test is used to test autocorrelation. Durbin-Watson test is also used to test autocorrelation. Right. If you are given this output, assume that you are given for the exam, this output, check whether the model is suffer from autocorrelation. Then you explain it, write in the hypothesis, null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis, and then see the probability value and check with the 5% significance level. Then you can confirm that if it is less than 5%, there is autocorrelation. If it is greater than 5%, no autocorrelation. Now go to the wave, residual diagnostics, heterozygosity test. Heterozygosity test. Go for the heterozygosity test. Then there are many tests. Brosch-Pagan, Godfrey test, Harvey test, Arch test, White test, Arch and White, and Brosch-Pagan Godfrey test. Those are the most commonly used method to test the heterozygosity. Is a Arch, BP test, then click OK. This is the Brosch-Pagan test, heterozygosity Brosch-Pagan Godfrey test. Right here, probability chi-square value, observe R squared and the corresponding probability value. Probability value is 0.87. Normally, I told you that heterozygosity issue normally comes for cross-sectional data, but for time series, it's very rarely we can see, because it is a data with the time, very rarely we can see the heterozygosity issue. But in this case, probability value, probability chi-square value is 0.8725. It is greater than 5%. Greater than 5%. That means if it is less than 5%, we accept our alternative, then we reject our alternative. That means we reject the hypothesis assumption of heterozygosity. We reject no heterozygosity, alternative hypothesis, then we accept null hypothesis. It means there is no heterozygosity. When the one assumption is violated, this heterozygosity, that assumption, so then we assume there is a no heterozygosity issue, that we accept. Then our model is good in terms of heterozygosity, that this assumption is not violated. Now go to the another test. For multicollinearity, we check by using correlation table. Here go to the histogram normality test. Normality test. By using here, you can see that Jack-Behra test. Jack-Behra test. Normality can be checked. Is checked by Jack-Behra test. what's write down the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis is normality. Alternative hypothesis is not normal. If the probability value is greater than 5%, we accept alternative. In this case, Jack Berra value, probability Jack probability Jack Berra value, probability well correspond to the Jack Berra value is 0.000878. It is less than 5%. It means that residuals are not normally distributed. Then the two assumptions is violated. Other assumption is checking the correlation table. In the checking the correlation table, you can see that group statistics correlation. Real export, real exchange rate, LTV. Now you can see that the relationship between independent variables RER and RGDP, it is minus 0.7. It is very weak relationship. That means no strong relationship between independent variables, that means RER and RGDP, that means there is no hetero, so no multicollinearity issue. In this model, two assumptions are violated. First, there is autocorrelation issue in this model. There is a normality issue in this model. Other two assumptions, multicollinearity and the heterozygosity, those two issues, assumptions are fulfilled. Then we can conclude, then our model, right, this model, conclusion, this model under the model efficiency. That's why it is important to check. Then this model is suffering from autocorrelation and normality. The model regression model is significant predict or explain real export. Right. Then what is the solution for this? What is the real solution for this? If there is an autocorrelation issue, the major issue is the autocorrelation, then if your data series is time series data, your analysis is not over, then we need to give remedies for this. For example, here in the autocorrelation, first, what are the remedies for this? Autocorrelation. If there there is an autocorrelation issue. Remedies for the for this, if there is an autocorrelation issue, go to the stationary. Go to the stationary to check and include a past or the lag values. Right, so then it's a go to the stationary to check and the unit root check, co-integration and autocorrelation. So then it is for the co-integration. Write Dickey Fuller test. Autocorrelation. Co-integration. Vector correction model. These other remedies. If the model suffer from autocorrelation, if the model suffer from, check your model data output. If the model suffer from multicollinearity, if two variables are highly correlated, variables, those should be independent variables. In this case, independent variables are the exchange rate and the GDP. These two variables, if two variables are highly correlated, one variable and remove one variable and example, if there is a highly correlated for example, there is a RER and RGDP correlation value, assume that correlation value is 0.85 number, that it means RER and RGDP are highly correlated. Solution is highly correlated variable, assume that RER, remove the highly correlated and then regress. That is the solution for that. If there is a heterostaticity issue, solution for that, solution is include, transform the data transformation. Data transformation means include data log values. Transform the data into log values and improve the log values. Improve the log values. Use these log values to estimate the model. That is the remedy for that. Vithanage. Why didn't you upload your data set? Your data set is analyze the data set by using correlation and then check the model efficiency. And correct the model. Until all the assumptions are fulfilled. Right, so then in this case, in this example, in this model, is suffering from autocorrelation. This is a serious issue. So then what is the remedy for that? Solution for that, for the autocorrelation, to include the stationarity and co-integration and vector error correction model. Right. Right. Now, this is the first few topics I cover: the model efficiency, autocorrelation, heteroscedasticity, and model normality and multicollinearity. And be familiar, if you are given the computer output, you can identify, if you can identify whether the model is suffer from, which assumption the model is violated, if you can explain, if you can interpret this, that is okay. Also the solution for each assumptions. If the model violate one of these assumptions, what are the solution for each violations, and how to interpret the regression output, autocorrelation, multicollinearity, and everything. Right, this is the first question I ask for the exam. Right, understanding, please follow the from the beginning to now for how to interpret the results. Before moving to the then go to the then this model is suffering from autocorrelation, then the solution is check the stationarity. Right, if your data set is not time series, is it a cross-sectional? If it is a cross-sectional, check the correlation. Have you checked the correlation? Right, so then regression. Results are, after regression and check, interpret the model by using R squared, R squared is shows the explanatory power of the model. What is the R square value? If R square, it doesn't matter whether R square is low or not, but if it's okay, then if it is 4.46 means 46% is explained by the variables. What is the F statistics? Probability value corresponding to the F statistics. If it is less than 5% means also overall model is good. Yeah, that is also fantastic. It is also the overall model is good. Then T statistics, how many variables are significant? One from three. Have you checked the model efficiency, heterozygosity, normality? Multicollinearity, are there any issue in multicollinearity? Correlation table? Right. Can you do this? Can you do the model efficiency? Right, check the model efficiency. Based on the F statistics, your overall the model is good, but in the out of three variables, one is significant. We cannot confirm, cannot use the your model, regression model, to give a proper conclusion until checking the model efficiency. Then the check the if now you have you are with your data set in your hand, check the model efficiency. It is not difficult. So then go to the estimate equation, but in this example, R export and R constant term RER and R GDP. Right, this is the model. In this model, so then go to the, what is the Durbin-Watson value? What is the Durbin-Watson value? What is the Durbin-Watson value? There is a, whatever the something, there is an issue. 1.14 means Durbin-Watson should be approximately 2. Right, Durbin-Watson value should be approximately 2 means it may be 1.5, greater than 1.5. Or less than, right, the Durbin-Watson value in your case, it is, there is a correlation issue. Right, can you add, tell me what is your dependent variable and independent variables? What is your dependent variable and what are the independent variables? Right, it is dependent is interest premium. Independent variables. Right, interest premium. Are there another term in practice? Yeah, this is in practice. So then previous interest premium, whether previous interest premium impact to the current interest premium. In practice, just interest is decided by the bank. Yeah, interest rate is determined by the bank based on the policy interest rate of the central bank. It is bank loans. Yes, this is lending rate and the deposit rate. So then, how to decide the lending rate and then deposit rate? That is the profit of the bank. Lending rate and the deposit rate, and then that gap is the profit of the bank. That interest rate is normally, you know, that a policy central bank policy based on the central bank policy interest rate. Commercial in theoretically we say that is based on the policy interest rate of the central bank. Commercial banks consider this and adjust their the lending rate and deposit rate. The gap between lending and the deposit rate is their profit. Yeah, then you consider this variable, collect these variables in particular time period. So then consider only the 2015 data. Are they 2016 data? Are they 2016? Ah, yeah, that's why. So then it is over 5 year period. That's why that is then times the data series are time series. If you collect, yeah, it is, you know, that you consider that over 5 years. For example, what is the over 5 years? Which period you consider? I can't understand how do you collect the data and then how do you upload the data to the Excel or the Right, so then so what is your sample size? 21. How you know that sample consists of 21? 21 the loan granted. Right, so then what are the columns? How do you know that enter the data? So then what are the columns you consider? Any column particular, you know, that year is the dependent variable, and the other independent variable collateral. Collateral you measure by using yes or no, whatever the value, some whatever the value. I don't know whether I can now go to the system. I'll check. Upload it. Not I will. So then, in the today, yeah, today upload. You know the data set to the today lecture. I'll try to get it. Right, upload it now. And upload it. Okay, I will. Right, please upload it to the under econometrics. Right, please upload there if you can upload to here. Data file, assignment one Dropbox. Project. It's okay. Right, so then let's analyze the data set first. It is relationship as a categorical variable. Is it as a categorical variable, and the collateral is a dummy variable? Am I right? Collateral is dummy variables. Yes. Okay. How to calculate the interest premium? Right, it's a continuous variable. It's a continuous variable as the ratio, actual interest rate, average weighted prime lending rate of the actual interest rate. It's a percentage also, it's a percentage of aftermath value. Maybe. Continuous, yes. Okay. Now go to the EVs. All other relationship. This is what is interest premium relationship. Right, it is risk. Right. Then it is. Go to the correlation, group statistics and the correlation table. Is the interest premium. Relationship and risk. Right, this is interest premium and the collateral, there is a negative relationship. Interest premium and the relationship is also negative. Risk positive. And there is no multicollinearity issue in this model. No multicollinearity issue. So then what is the assumptions you made? The interest, there is a positive relation, the collateral, higher the collateral, higher the interest premium, higher the collateral, or that opposite way. What is your hypothesis? So, what is your hypothesis? That is the hypothesis you made. Higher the collateral, lower the interest rate. So then that relationship is okay. So then the relationship is negative, moderate negative relationship with interest premium and the collateral. The relationship is also same. And the risk. And the interest premium and the relationship is also the same negative. Yeah, it shows the negative. So then in the risk, whatever it is risk. Higher the rate, higher the rate. But that is okay, only except all this. Anyway, so then it shows the relationship, but in this table shows that no relationship between relationship and collateral, right? No relationship between collateral and risk. Then the model is not suffering from multicollinearity. Right, then check the estimate equation, is interest premium. It is constant term. C is the your alpha or the constant. Then the relationship, collateral, and risk. Then click OK. R R squared is 40%, 30. Is the same results you got? It is 39. It's okay. Probability F value is overall model is good. And probability values. But risk is significant at not the 5% in your model. Collateral is a significant collateral. Collateral sign is okay. Collateral is a significant factor. And the risk is also the significant factor at 10% level of significance. 90% confidence level, the risk is significant. Then you can consider that 95%. This is not a relationship. Is not relationship is also the you know that in your model. Relationship is not the significant, also the sign is also incorrect. But run the model ignoring this variable. Relationship, remove the relationship, then see what happens. If we remove the variable relationship, now you can see that R square it is going down. It's 39, but this same thing. It is same thing. Keep as it is. Nothing happened to this asset. It's statistics. Okay. Here also not significant relationship. It's 39%. These two are significant, then you can consider that collateral, the sign is correct, and it is statistically significant at the 95% significance level. But the risk also the significant, though your positive sign is correct, also it is significant at the 90%. Right, it is significant at the 90%. Then these two variables, this is 90% at 90%, this is significant. This is significant at 95%. Then overall the model is good, because probability F value is less than 5%, then the overall model is good. R squared is also 39%, but there is an issue in the Durbin-Watson statistics. Anyway, let's check the residual analysis, the model efficiency, before finalizing this model for conclusion. Check the whether your model fulfill all the assumptions. So then go to the VIV if you are working with me, and then go to the VIV, the residual diagnostics. Go to the VIV residual diagnostics and go to the head cross elasticity test first. If it is a head cross elasticity, Broch, Fagan, Godfrey test. Right? So then, now I can see that observe R squared. So then observe R squared saha ekata, so then probability chi square value corresponding to the observed R squared. The value is 0.1181. Then your hypothesis for heterozygosity checking. Hypothesis is null hypothesis is null hypothesis is no heterozygosity. Alternative is heterozygosity. Right? If the probability value, right? If the probability chi square value is probability chi value in this model is 0.1181. Right, it is greater than 95% confidence level. That is greater than 5%. It means that we reject our alternative hypothesis. alternative hypothesis එක reject කරනවා, that means heterozygosity කියන එක reject කරනවා, that means එක reject කරනවා කියලා කියන්නේ it is automatically accept the no heterozygosity. No heterozygosity means ඔයාලගේ sample එකේ equal variance එකක් තියෙනවා, ඒ කියන්නේ sample එක bias වෙලා නැහැ කියන එක. Sample is not biased. Then what is the tenin gatte kira? So then if the sample is biased or not, assume that is a, if you are doing a study relating to the small firms and the big firms and then considering them together, ekolange loan profit, you know that in practice firm ika bigger firms ala, so then profit is higher than the small firms. If we put everything together, එතකොට so then unequal variance එකක් එනවා. The but in this example මේ data set එකේ it is a very good sign because there is a no heterozygosity. ඒ කියන්නේ equal variance එකක් තියෙනවා. ඒ කියන්නේ sample එක bias වෙලා නැහැ. ඒ නිසා this model fulfill the assumptions of homozygosity කියන එක. ඒක good sign එකක්. And so we reject the alternative hypothesis. It means we accept the null hypothesis. So null hypothesis we accept the model error terms residuals are homozygostic. There is the equal variance. Right. And so model like no heterozygosity issue. Right. Then is it clear for you? Better check karanne. So then it's observed R squared and the probability corresponding to the observed R squared. Eka thamai check karanne. Me value eka then 0.1181. That value should be less than 5%. Ehemanan api kiyanawa there is a no heterozygosity kiyala. No heterozygosity means equal variance කියන එක. Equal variance කියලා කියන්නේ in other words your sample එක bias නැහැ කියන එක. Right? It is a good sign. දැන් ඊළඟට චෙක් කරමු. අනිත් එක ඔය මේ මොඩල් එකේ නැහැ. මල්ටිකොලිනියරිටි issue එක. ඒකට මල්ටිකොලිනියරිටි issue එක නැහැ කියලා කියන්නේ අපි correlation table එකකින්. ඒ නිසා මල්ටිකොලිනියරිටි issue එකත් මේ මොඩල් එකේ නැහැ. එතකොට assumptions දෙකක් fulfill වෙනවා. දැන් අපි චෙක් කරමු normality test එක. එතන මේ මොඩල් එකේ normality කියන එකක් තියෙනවා. ඒ නිසා මේ errors are normally distributed. එතකොට ඒ assumption එකත් මේකේ fulfill වෙනවා. ඇත්තට ජාක් බේරා වැලියු එක මෙතන greater than 5% වෙනවා. ඒ නිසා අපි not normality කියන එක reject කරනවා. ජාක් probability ජාක් බේරා වැලියු එක. එතන මෙතන probability ජාක් බේරා වැලියු එක 0.51. ඒ වැලියු එක less than 5% වුණොත් අපි අපේ hypothesis එක, එතකොට අපි අපේ hypothesis එක වෙන්නේ normality එකේ null hypothesis එක normality. Alternative hypothesis එක not normality. Probability value එක මෙතන ඉන්නේ ජාක් බේරා වැලියු එක. ඒ ජාක් බේරා වැලියු probability value corresponding to the ජාක් බේරා. එහෙම ලියන්න probability value probability value correspond to the ජාක් බේරා is 0.51. It is greater than 5%. See the pahata vada vedi. Enisa we reject. We reject alternative. Alternative reject karna kya ne? Not normality kya ne? Reject karna. Again we accept none. Accept the model is the error term is normally distributed. Error term is normally distributed. The model may model assumptions to not fulfill whenever තව එක assumption එකක් තියෙනවා hetero sorry auto correlation කියන එක ඩර්වින් වොට්සන් එකිනුත් අපිට ඒක කියන්න පුළුවන් නමුත් අපි මේක චෙක් කරමු residual diagnostics serial correlation LM test ඒකත් අපි lag values දෙකක් අපි එකට දෙනවා දෙකක් අපි දින බලමු ඉතින් මේකේ ඇත්තටම ලොකුවටම මෙතන සියයට approximately 5ක් විතර ඇතරම ලොකුවට මේකේ auto correlation issue එකක් නැහැ මොකද 0.04 ඒ නිසා මේකේ ලොකු issue එකක් මේ model එකේ නැහැ serial correlation එක value එකක් අපි දුන්නත් යනවා මොඩල් එකේ මේ ඩර්වින් වොට්සන් ඒ කියන්නේ ඔටෝ කෝරිලේෂන් එකකුත් ඇතරම මේ මොඩල් එකේ නැහැ. ඒ නිසා මේ මොඩල් එක මොඩල් එෆිෂන්සි වලදී ඇතරම මේ මොඩල් is this model is very good model to give a conclusion and as well as you know that for prediction as well. Then you can use this model because of no autocorrelation, no heteroscedasticity, no normality. So in very rarely we can collect that type of data set, because this data set has no any multicollinearity issue, no heteroscedasticity issue, no normality issue, and the no autocorrelation issue as well. Then the model is good for prediction. Then this model is good for prediction as well. It is an estimate equation. It is right. This is the model. Then this model, there is a model stability test. Right? This is the stability test, and then you can do the finally stability test as well. Then you can use, there are many type of test. Use this one, recursive estimate OLS, because your model is OLS. Then do this one, recursive estimate model. Under this model stability test, under the stability test, there is there are many type of test under that category as well. Use the this test, second one, CUSUM test, right? CUSUM test, do it, and click OK. Right. इतर making किया ने may this is your regression line. This line should go may red line देखा अतरें यान रोने. Then the model is stable. Making किया लगे that shows that model is stable. किया ने का ए may के दी 5% वाला මේ මොඩල් මේ ලයින් if model is not stable නම් මේ ලයින් එක මේ blue line එක go beyond the red lines මේ පැත්තෙන් හරි මේ පැත්තෙන් හරි so then go beyond the red lines the මේ මොඩල් එකේ so then මේ blue line එක තියෙන්නේ inside the red lines ඒ කියන්නේ මොඩල් එක stable model එකක් to explain the interest premium ඒ නිසා මේකත් under the model efficiency ek yate model stability kiyala liyala me table ekak cut karala paste karana right are there any questions so then this is one other prashna thiyenada metana so any clarifications for regarding the model efficiency and then so then you need to write the analysis section right analysis section එක ලියනකොට dependent variable එක විතරයි continuous variable එකක් විදිහට තියෙන්නේ ඒ නිසා dependent variable එක line graph එකකින් මුලින්ම graphical analysis එකක් විදිහට line graph එකකින් පෙන්වන්න පෙන්නලා so then analysis එක ලියනකොට interest premium එක line graph එකකින් පෙන්වන්න. දැන් මේක for example මෙතන ගත්තොත් මෙතන ඔබක් කිහිල්ලා graph එකට යන්න. මෙතන මේ ඔක්කොම graph අඳින්න බෑ අනිත් ඒවා categorical variable නිසා. interest premium කියන එක විතරක් අඳින්න පුළුවන්. Right, make a. We can say that we have a graphic. Again, I am saying that you can say something about the interest premium. එනිසා මේක analysis or methodology එක දැන් already ලියලානේ. So then you have written the methodology. Methodology ලිව්වට පස්සේ data analysis section එක. Data analysis section එකේ interest premium එක ගැන ඔයාලට මේ graph එකත් මේක cut කරලා paste කරන්න පුළුවන් Word document එකට. Paste කරලා මේක ගැන so then you can write something. ඊට පස්සේ ඔයාට අනිත් variables ටිකට මේ interest premium එකත් එක්ක descriptive statistics mean mode ඒ ටික අරගෙන පොඩි analysis එකක් කරන්න. එහෙම නැත්නම් categorical data categorical data bar graph විදිහට data presentation එකක් කරන්න descriptive analysis එකක් right analysis එක analysis chapter එක and descriptive statistics descriptive analysis කියලා heading එකක් යන්න descriptive analysis ඊට පස්සේ descriptive analysis එකෙන් පස්සේ correlation table එක add කරන්න correlation table and write something about the relationship is the correlation table එකෙන් measure කරන්න strength of the relationship ඊට පස්සේ regression analysis correlation table එකට පස්සේ regression analysis එක යන්න regression and output එක explain කරන්න ඊට පස්සේ model efficiency එකට යන්න efficiency වල explain කරන්න heteroscedasticity table එක මේකෙන් cut කරලා paste කරලා you can write 2-3 sentence normality correlation table like and autocorrelation මේ මොඩල් එකේ නැහැ ඒ නිසා ඔටෝ කෝරිලේෂන් ඒ ටික මොඩල් ඩෙෆිෂන්සි ඊට පස්සේ මොඩල් ස්ටැබිලිටි කියලා හෙඩින් එකක් අරන් ඒක යටතේ මොඩල් ස්ටැබිලිටි එක යටතේ මේ ග්‍රාෆ් එක CUSUM ටෙස්ට් එක කරලා ඒකෙන් මොඩල් එකේ ස්ටැබිලිටි එක ෂෝ කරන්න then the conclusion ඒ නිසා so then you can write conclusion එක ඊට පස්සේ ලියන්න. Right. But anything you want to clarify now? Right, ethic dala, so then you can submit the report then. It is easy for you, so then you cut and then paste to the Word document. Then the collateral you consider as a dummy variable. You consider the collateral as a dummy variable. Yeah, one means it is a yes no question right no need that right it is a yes no question Yeah, if you consider that we are enter karanne nathi yes now 1 and the no na 0 kiyalan yeah e dummy api dummy ekak widiyata gattot thamai api 0 1 ekenne etara dan yes කියලා කියපු උත්තරේ තමයි එතන 1 කියලා ඇවිල්ලා තින්නේ දැන් මේ output එකේ මේකේ මේ 1 එක තමයි output එක තමයි ඇවිල්ලා තියෙන්නේ දැන් මෙතන ගත්තොත් right මේ ගත්තොත් මෙතන මේ මේවා එක variable එකයි ගත්තේ so then here මෙතන මේ ඇවිල්ලා තියෙන්නේ the collateral 6ද collateral 6ද premium කියන එක. ඒතර ages keep එක තමයි මේ ඇවිල්ලා තියෙන්නේ. 6ද collateral 6ද premium කියන එක. එනිසාර descriptive statistics වලදී collateral කියන column එක අරගෙන ඔයාලට pie chart එකකින් පෙන්වන්න පුළුවන් මෙච්චරක් collateral වල මෙතරම් percentage එකක් yes කිව්වා මෙතරම් percentage එකක් no කිව්වා කියලා එතෙන්දී descriptive analysis එක යටතේ එතනදී ලියන්න එතෙන්දී graph එකක් graphical analysis එකක් කරන්න පුළුවන් descriptive statistics යටතේ එක එක variables වලට graph අඳින්න එතන interest premium එක continuous එකක් හින්දා line graph එකක් then collateral කියන එක yes no question එකක් නිසා ඒකට එතකොට pie chart එකක් තමයි හරියන්නේ. ඒතර මම හිතන්නේ ඊට පස්සේ තවත් වෙන relationship කියන එකත් ඒකත් pie chart එකක් වගේ ගියොත් ඒකත් හොඳයි. අනිත් එක risk කියන එක ආයිත් මම හිතන හැටියට line graph එක. ඒ නිසා ඒ variables ගැන behavior එක descriptive explanation එකක් දෙන්න by using graph. ඊට පස්සේ correlation table එක දාලා පෙන්නන්න ඕනේ so then strength of the relationship එක. ඒකෙන් අපිට පෙන්නන්නේ impact එකක්. අපිට පෙන්නන්නේ the strength of the relationship එක. ඊට පස්සේ regression analysis එක දාලා ඊට පස්සේ model efficiency ටිකත් කියලා ඊට පස්සේ model stability ටිකත් කියලා ඊට පස්සේ ඔයාගේ conclusion එක දෙන්න. මොකද මේ model වලින් කියන්නේ ඔයාගේ conclusion එක is more realistic කියන එක. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ ටික check කරනවා කියලා කියන්නේ check කළා ඒක ඔක්කොම fulfill වෙනවා කියලා කියන්නේ the conclusion based on your model is realistic කියන එක. තව you can do that මේක කරලා මේක upload කරන්න ඔයාට project in business එකේදීත් මම හිතන්නේ මෙතෙන්ට නිකන් analysis එක වා කරා නම් හොඳයි කියලා මට හිතෙනවා මොකද ඒක added advantage එකක් for you analysis එකක් කරලාම මේක complete analysis section as well ඊට අමතරව ඔයාට මෙතෙන්දී අර මේ data set එකත් එක්ක ඕනනම් interest premium එක forecast කරන්න පුළුවන්. ඒ නිසා අපි ERIMA model එකෙන් interest premium එක forecast කරන්න පුළුවන් ඒ topic එක හරහා යට. මොකද box Jenkins methodology එක යටතේ අපි කරන්නේ එක මොකක් හරි එක variable එකක් අරගෙන ඒක forecasting කරන එකක්. නමුත් හැබැයි ඒක එතකොට ඊය එකක් අවශ්‍ය data. Anyway, so then you have any questions regarding this? Or now you can answer for any questions or write your report. Are you confident about writing your report now? Right. Any questions? Any clarifications, please? Right. Enang, so then next coming week is our last lecture. Most probably lecture ekama patanganna vele, so then I will have to start at 5 o'clock. Let's discuss some practice questions for the exam. In the meantime, so then do the analysis and interpret based on these headings and upload it to the LMS. Okay then. See you on next week. See you next week for the in our last lecture.